Pondicherry Andamans. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome our Deputy Director General, Commodore K.S. Ayyappa Vishishta Seva Medal, esteemed guests, our officers, the PI staff, the associated NCC officers, central and state employees, and our young and enthusiastic cadets to our 65th NCC Day celebrations. I will now read out to you the annual report of our directorate for the year 2013-14. As you know, our training year commences immediately after these sessions are opened and our enrollment for the year starts.
Distinguished guests, officers of the directorate, our staff, ladies, gentlemen, and my dear cadets, Vanakkam, good afternoon to all of you. Today is the 65th anniversary of the NCC, and normally we have in our midst our Secretary of Youth Welfare and the Minister, but unfortunately both of them have been unable to be present today because of pressing. This present strength of 13.4 lakh cadets, NCC's reach has spread to about 617 directorate districts in the country. And at present, the NCC has 666 Army, 61 Air Force, and 61 Naval units, which are manned by officers, JCOs, and NCOs of all the three services. In the next 5 years, the NCC's strength is planned to be increased to about 15 lakhs, and phase-wise accretion for the overall increase has already commenced. NCC's training is aimed at bringing about a change in the mindsets of our cadets and imbibing in them the attributes of discipline, honesty, diligence, camaraderie, selflessness, and patriotism. Training is provided through a broad array of activities divided distinctly into four categories. Firstly, institutional training, which includes camp training. Secondly, social service activities. Thirdly, adventure and sports. And fourthly, the youth exchange program with foreign countries. The NCC is aware of these changing aspirations and conducts a holistic review of its training philosophy to try and make it more meaningful. The government of Tamil Nadu has continuously been most gracious in sanctioning various welfare measures for the NCC. Our long-standing request for opening an NCC academy has been sanctioned by the government in Madurai at a cost of 12 crores. Construction of an equestrian obstacle training course at Chennai at a sum of rupees 3 lakhs has been sanctioned, and rupees 4 lakhs have been sanctioned for construction of a firing range at Dindigul. Aero and ship modeling grants have been doubled. 20 lakhs have been sanctioned for purchase of precision sporting rifles for the training of our cadets. Also, the daily allowance for ANOs and cadets have been enhanced from rupees 30 to rupees 100. These are but a few examples that highlight the immense support that the NCC continues to receive from the government of Tamil Nadu. And I will not hesitate in saying that the government of Tamil Nadu is probably amongst the most proactive of all state governments insofar as the NCC is concerned. Today, the Tamil Nadu, Puducherry and Andaman and Nicobar Directorate has spread over 793 schools, 374 colleges, with a total strength of 1,05,084. Our directorate has continually contributed towards nurturing highly disciplined and training youth, and with the unflinching and gracious support of the Tamil Nadu government, we are confident that our directorate will go from strength to strength. Jai.
Fire me! Take it! Take it! Take it! Move!